Yeah, back to Lake Geneva.
In color. And that color has survived a little better, it looks like.
So there's a little blue in it, isn't there?
Not much of a day for sailing.
No.
I don't place that dock.
That could be my boat right there, coming around the blue.
You were I-3.
I-3, that's it.
Now, who did you have as crew, usually? Was it a different group?
Well, Kenny Kepke sailed with me, Bruce Pope sailed with me, George Kiefer sailed with me.
They all had their own boats, didn't they?
Yeah, but they all had sea boats. I had the only E. There I am alone. Whoops.
those aren't E's, are they?
That probably was an old E, I-20. That was Harold Huff. Sure.
Just looks short.
Yeah. Now, he was the old guy of the fleet. You know, he was probably, who knows, 60, 65, something like that. And a very courtly gentleman. We had a pretty good E fleet there. We sailed Fridays and Sundays.
How many E boats were there? I mean, was it 5 or 10 on the whole lake, or 20?
No, I think we had about 20 on our racing fleet. It was a pretty good sized fleet.
It seems to me you said there used to be a lot of A boats back in those days.
Yes.
I mean, more than 4 or 5.
Yes, more like 10. Again, as active racers, there were other boats on the lake, but they didn't race actively. It's a windy day.
Looks like you've got a woman crew there.
Who was the lady on our crew that time?
That's not Mom, is it?
No. It was probably Margaret Redeker. See, we had a 450-pound weight limit. Normally, we'd sail with 3, but when it was blowing hard, we'd try to load up as close to the 450 as we could, and we'd try to get ourselves somebody who would weigh 100 or 110 or somewhere around there, which usually meant we had a girl. But the interesting thing about it was that sometimes I was able to get Buddy Melgus, who was a kid at the time, and obviously he was a great guy to have as a crew because he knew what to do.
Even back then?
Even back then, you bet.
He's the one that went on to win the America's Cup?
Yes. I'd like to think because of the training I gave him, but that would be self-serving.
And he's also the guy that sold us the M16 up at the lake,
right,
if I remember.
Right.
I still remember him delivering that after he'd won the American Cup.
Yes, that was impressive, wasn't it? That was very impressive. That's the yacht club pier at that time.
You know, I think that launch in the back there survived even to my day. They had something like that.
Yes, that was Ernie Schmidt's boat, which was used almost always as an official boat. That's me.
So you're probably, what, 17, 18 at this point?
About that, Back to Lake Geneva.
Well, there are a lot of boats. That must be some sort of an open.
That's probably a regatta.
A lot of boats. Now, did you tell me at one time when they raced the A's on really windy days that the spectators had a tough time keeping up?
Well, yeah, that was true of the E's too. If you had a downwind run and you had a big spinnaker set and everything else was right, the boats would plane and they'd get up to perhaps 25 miles an hour very, very fast. And of course, most of these motorboats didn't go that fast. That's a pretty exciting experience to get a spinnaker set in one of those boats and have it blossom out and go. Well, those are E's, sure enough, I think. Pretty classic motorboats there.
Yeah.